Well, the solar eclipse is just over a month away now. It will be on Monday, April 8th, and it is expected to be the longest and most visible solar eclipse in over 100 years. So you've never seen it yet. To make sure that you can view this amazing event safely, we have Nicole Bajic from the Cole Eye Institute, one of the best at the Cleveland Clinic, with the very latest for us. Nicole, welcome. It's great to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me. It's a pleasure to be here.
Oh, thanks. We have so many questions about this. So let's get right to it. Basically, if you do not use glasses for yourself, for your kids, wherever, you can do permanent damage to your eyes, even cause blindness to your eyes. I mean, this is very serious. So we're excited about this event, but we also want to make sure you can view it safely.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, I know this is a very special event and we all want to partake, right? But the big overall message that I want to push forward is, you know, don't let a few minutes of, you know, viewing this cool event affect your vision for the rest of your life. So make sure you're doing it safely.
So what if someone says, well, I don't have glasses and I wasn't prepared for this and now I'm outside running errands. I want to just peek. I want to just look up real quick.
So the only safe way to directly peek at the eclipse is if you are in the path of totality and during totality. So that is when the moon is completely covering the sun. Now, it's really important to remember that not everyone's going to be in the path of totality, just a small strip of the U.S. And so if you go onto NASA's website, they actually have a great graphic that, you know, highlights which areas are going to be in the path of totality. And again, it's only during the period of totality when the moon is completely covering the sun.
And you wouldn't even know to do that. So basically, you need to be prepared and you need to make sure that your eyes are covered and safe. We're going to show you a couple. Let's talk about some of the glasses that are out there, because we want to make sure wherever you're purchasing them from, whether it's Amazon or a store, that they are the legit real stuff, because there are some ones out there that actually don't have the safe filters on them.
Yeah, unfortunately, as we're seeing in so many different industries, there are a lot of counterfeits out there. And so you want to make sure that you're buying them from a verified source. The American Astronomical Society actually has a list of verified sources to purchase them from.
And this is something, they're not expensive. So it's not like you have to buy $100 glasses, so you're trying to get around and buy the $5 ones. They're really not that expensive.
Yeah.
So let's talk about something too that's pretty important. People are going to be using their cell phones. They're going to want to document this, take video, take photos from their phones or also their cameras. Maybe even people will be using binoculars so they can really good see a great view, or a telescope. How's the safe way? What is the safe way to view it through those instrumentations?
Sure. So if you wanted to view the eclipse through another instrument, or, you know, binocular, telescope,
phones, you
need to have an appropriate solar filter. So it is not enough to be using the eclipse glasses over. And in fact, that's actually dangerous, because the lens systems in those can actually burn a hole through the glasses. So you cannot wear just the eclipse glasses over the, you know, telescope, binoculars, whatever. You need an appropriate solar filter.
Okay, so again, go online, make sure you do your research. We have a month now to prepare for this, so make sure you get something safely for your phone, for your binoculars, or a telescope. What are some other news? And actually, how does it hurt our eyes? What does it do to the makeup of our eye?
So it can cause a phototoxic injury called solar retinopathy, which can cause blurred vision or a blind spot in your vision. It can be temporary, typically resolving around 3 to 6 months, but unfortunately, it can also be permanent.
No kidding. I remember my son in a class that he took, he said, Mom, you should never, because when we look at the sunset, he'll say, it's actually, my doctor said, and one of his professors said, it's never actually even truly safe to watch the sun and to view the sun. So talk a little bit about that, what that does to our eyes, how it impacts them.
Yeah, so, you know, any prolonged sun gazing is, you know, a significant risk factor for, you know, the solar retinopathy. So, you know, it does cause damage to the very sensitive cells in our retina. So, you know, we want to be mindful and avoid, you know, direct sun gazing, you know, at any time, really, but especially during the eclipse.
One of our greatest senses that, of course, we want to protect. You're not looking to find new patients.
Yeah, you're preaching to the choir.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. So, well, thank you for being here today.
Oh,
also, sunglasses are not going to do it. No matter how dark they are, we want to remind people that's not going to do it.
So this is an excellent point. Sunglasses are not sufficient, because the eclipse glasses are actually 1,000 times darker than sunglasses.
Wow.
So don't get, you know, tricked into that. You must wear the eclipse glasses.
Okay, that's the way it is. All right, thank you, Doctor. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.